So, hello everyone. Welcome to the series named Conversation with Kushal once again. Today we have a special guest named Divyansh Jain. Just to give you a brief introduction about Divyansh, he has secured an All India rank 10 in his CA finals and he has graduated from Shriram College of Commerce, post which he was working in Deutsche Bank for 1 year as a corporate analyst. After pursuing his CA finals, he got into Boston Consulting Group, that is one of the top 3 consulting firms across the globe. And now finally, he is into one of the top private equity firms, that is Blackstone. So today we are going to discuss his entire journey, what kept him motivated and how he was able to prepare for all these interviews and what are the traits which these companies look for. So thank you so much, Divyansh, for accepting my invitation and heartiest congratulations for all your achievements.
Thank you so much, Kushal. Thank you for having me. And I think thank you for doing this because this should be very helpful for all the young ones who are watching this. So thank you for the entire process.
Exactly. Thanks a lot. So Divyansh, let's go through your journey itself right from your graduation days. So we would be conducting this in a candid manner and we would just discuss your entire journey. So asking about your SRCC days, I just wanted to ask you, like, people have a question that whether it is beneficial to do BCom from a regular college or whether they should opt for correspondence, because there is an opportunity cost which is involved if you do BCom from a regular college. So what is your take on it and how SRCC has helped you to gain that exposure which you have right now?
Right, I think for me, SRCC was the biggest turning point in my life because over there, once I came to SRCC, I realized how smart everyone was around me and that really motivated me to pursue excellence in everything that I do for life. So before that, even mediocrity was something that I could have celebrated, but once I got through SRCC, that is something that I can never do for life now. So that is my biggest takeaway that I had from SRCC, besides the fact that I interacted with some of the smartest people who I'm still in touch with. And from networking point of view or from the platform and the exposure that you get, I think that way SRCC was truly a big gift for me. At the same time, I know a lot of people who did not get through the top colleges at, say, DU or in, say, Mumbai or Calcutta, and they decided that CA is something they could pursue. So instead of going to an average college, they decided to, you know, go through correspondence and then just pursue their articleship in CA. Where I see that sometimes, you know, very intelligent students do not get the best of marks in the class 12 board exams because it's probably not their lucky day. And but they deserve the best truly. And even if you go to an average college and then go for a CAT or a GMAT, you can still have your chances to get to a good B school, get the right jobs. But once you get that correspondence tag, that baggage really stays with you for a very long time. So you need to take the call that, okay, you probably did not get the right score for your boards, but do you still have it in you to, you know, cover that gap by doing it, adding that MBA to your CV and, you know, getting yourself back to the top. So you need to take a call of where you want. If CA is the only priority that you have and you decide that once I have CA, I don't need anything else, then you can take a call that, okay, I'll save a lot of time if I go through a correspondence route. So you can do that. But otherwise, I think a lot of times you should not always only do things that fit to your agenda perfectly, because things that I learned outside the classroom in my college from people around me, I think that is something I could not have learned anywhere else. So I think that way, college life is very important to me, to what I am.
That's right. So to summarize, I think if a person who only wants to practice into CA or get into CA, he can do a correspondence. But if he wants an overall exposure of college life as well as an MBA in the future, I think he should definitely go for regular college. Yeah, I think that makes sense. So after your SRCC, you applied for Deutsche Bank and you got a job at Deutsche Bank. So you worked there for 1 year. So how was your overall work experience in Deutsche Bank and what was the profile?
At Deutsche, I was a corporate finance analyst in the investment banking team. I was a corporate finance in the Europe, Middle East, Africa, oil and gas team. Okay. So straight out of college, I think the best part of Deutsche was, you know, it laid the fundamental base of my career in finance. So it's there where we had a 1 month bootcamp training about financial modeling and all the basics of finance and everything that we learned. So I think Excel is something that we all knew in college, but we just knew the basics. Okay, there's a sum function or there's a multiply function. But the ultimate functions that you use on a day-to-day work basis when you don't use a mouse and you try to do Excel completely only via the keyboard. So these are things that, you know, Deutsche helped me really perfect and polish myself. Even, I mean, when you're making a presentation, that the font size is something that's very particular. The people are very finicky about the font size, the font type, about the color scheme you're choosing, about borders. So these are things that Deutsche helped me, you know, focus on. that okay, and make me realize what are the things really important that an analyst or associate should have in either in consulting, banking, or in private equity. So that way it really helped me. The other part that Deutsche helped me, I got the chance to work at London, and for a 21-year-old guy working in London was a phenomenal experience. And it is a very global team where we were 11 of us from 7 different countries. So that platform thing is something that I would definitely not get anywhere else at that age. So that's why I think I was very lucky that I got that chance, and it really helped me overall.
Exactly, that's awesome to hear. Like having an exposure in London for a 21-year-old, that is really a very good opportunity as well. So after your experience of Deutsche Bank, I was also going through your Zoom talk wherein you were just telling about the preparation of interview tips. So in that Zoom talk, you said that then after that you applied for CA, you continued your CA articleship because your dad is a CA, and if not anything else, you would continue his practice as well. So that was the reason of continuing CA, right? So,
I wanted to get back to academics as well, right? Because I thought I was in the oil and gas team, and I was not sure I wanted to do that for life. Because I would have specialized in oil and gas then, but back then I decided I'll come back to CAD. So I completed my CFA as well, and then also CA was something that I always wanted to complete.
Okay, so you completed CFA before your articleship itself, like after your Deutsche Bank.
So I completed my CFA level 1 and level 2 when I was at Deutsche, and I completed my CFA level 3 during my articleship when I was preparing for my CFA as well. Okay. So I completed my CFA before my CA. Yeah.
Okay, alright. Guys, just to tell all of you, like I was just going through the interview preparation tips video which Divyansh has shared. So he has made a very concise presentation as well. So I'm going to give the link in the description box. If you really want, it is a detailed 1-hour video, so you can also watch it. That is a very insightful video, and thank you so much, Divyansh, for that video as well. So let's continue now. After your CA finals, you secured an All India rank 10, and then you applied to Boston Consulting Group. Of course, it is a dream company for many CA aspirants as well. So how was your work experience at the Boston Consulting Group? Like, if you were to define, how did a typical day look like at the Boston Consulting Group?
Right. So at BCG, I think the best part was that every day was very different from the previous one. And that is something that made the entire experience very enjoyable. You're working on different pieces, on different cases. In a period of 1 year, I think I got to work on 4 or 5 different pieces altogether with different clients. And with every time you're working with a different team as well. And more from the client or the work, you learn from the team. So that way, it was a very enjoyable experience. I wish that COVID had not struck in February and March, and I could have gotten an even better experience, you know, meeting the team on a day-to-day basis, instead of just meeting them on Zoom calls. But okay, we can't complain right now. But otherwise also, I think consulting is something that really gives you the right start to a career, no matter what you want to do. And if you want to start up on your own, if you want to go into the industry, you want to go to a CFO or CXO track, or you want to go get into, I mean, if you want to continue as a consultant only, or if you want to get into private equity, if you want to do an MBA, whatever you want to do, I think consulting really opens you up for the entire gamut of opportunities that are out there.
Right. Okay. So you worked in BCG for how many years?
1 year.
Okay, August 1 year. So post which you applied in Blackstone.
During my I think after 8-9 months of BCG, I had applied.
So how did you get to know about Blackstone? So do they approach, or how did you get to know about them?
So I think Blackstone has always been a dream company. I think since the first time I heard about them, right after college. And then I did a research about how are their operations in India and everything, and got to learn about the firm. And it, you know, it was something that was a dream job for me. And back then, I think I did not know of any CA getting into the track. And they used to mostly hire folks from IIT Bombay or IIT Kharagpur, most of the top IITs. So, and they did not have a history of hiring anyone from a commerce background since 2005 when they started their India operations.
Okay.
But nonetheless, I knew very sure that if I get a chance, I'll definitely apply for this. And I think Blackstone invites all consultants and investment bankers from the top firms in India to apply for the position. So like everyone else around, I definitely attended the workshop and applied for the position. Okay. And things into place for me, fortunately.
That's great. So that was my follow-up question. As you mentioned that IITians, like, they are hired by Blackstone. So is it that they are preferred more over CAs in these PE, VC and consulting firms?
I think there's no direct preference that, okay, we will we prefer IITians over CAs or anything like that. It's just been that the trend has been such that since the first time probably private equities or VC started the operations in India, the first batch that probably got hired would have been IITians.
Okay.
Or they were the ones who hired. So they probably would have preferred to get their campus students back to when they were forming the initial team. So, you know, that's how the legacy grows. But I think later on, once you go, I mean, the bias does not stand for a long time, and ultimately everyone wants the best candidate for a position. And the other reason is that in positions for VCs and PEs, it's very important that you know how to understand the business and the operations as well. That is, and you can, the analytical power that you learn when you're preparing for, as for an engineer, I think they understand the value chain of a business very well. And for CAs, while at the same time, we are tested a lot on memory. Analysis is something that we are not really tested on so far as well as IITians are tested on. I think that probably needs the gap that the institute should cover up with time. Yeah, I hope we can.
Yeah, that's fair actually. So like moving out from a memory based questions to an application based questions, I think that would be helpful in further process as well. That's great. So Blackstone has hired CA for the first time, you said, right? Since 2005.
So in the analyst associate program where folks like us get hired, this is the first time in the 15-year history. There are two CAs in Blackstone so far, but they were lateral hires directly at the MD level at the VC.
Okay. All right. So how was the feeling like? It would have been amazing. You were the first CA in the past 15 years who have been hired.
I mean, it felt great, but since because at the same time, I really wanted it for a very long time and I saw myself that, okay, now I need to prepare for this. So it did not come as big of a surprise because it was something I was having. It was more a feeling of happiness than the fact that plus I was not aware that for 15 years, they never hire a CA. I was not really aware of that.
Okay.
I got to know that later because I was just focusing that this is a company that I should want to work for. And fortunately, I was not, because if had I known that, okay, they don't hire CAs, I would have probably been discouraged or something like that.
Yeah, exactly.
But it never happened.
Good that you didn't know about it. Yeah, so then you applied in Blackstone and then you were fortunate enough to get shortlisted as well. So how did you prepare for the Blackstone interview and how was your overall interview experience at Blackstone if you were to guide the CA aspirants?
Right. So I think in Blackstone, I had a written test and then post that there were 9 interviews. So overall, every interview is very different experience from the other one. So, and they're very intense. And so for the students, I think, personally, I think have an advantage because they are used to doing accounts and solving cost problems or SFM problems. They know exactly how to approach them when IITs could struggle over there. So I think over there, think I did well because of my preparation that I had done for my CA. And at the same time, I think when it comes to the interviews, they really look at how you analyze industry problems, how you understand issues of different companies. They would want to see whether you're asking the right questions or not. So that's something I feel that they could ask you something about a problem in an industry that you're not aware of. So it's to get to the problem, what are the right questions that you ask? And then with the information that you have, how do you absorb it and synthesize it to find a solution? So I think that is important for every interview. And that's why for that, I think it's very important to read about what's happening around for different companies, businesses. I think that habit of reading that I had formed once I came to BCG, I think that I started reading a lot about different industries and different businesses. So that reading portion really helped me in my interviews that I had. And other than that, obviously, how strong a profile you have overall also matters.
Okay.
So when we talk about whether CFA helps or not, CFA can't make or break your career, but it's good to have.
Yeah, exactly. So if you have a CFA, like additional qualification, that would just be an add-on. But then that's not mandatory. That's what you're trying to say, right?
I think it worked for me. See, there were 9 people interviewing me. And even if 4-3 really said that, okay, he has a CFA also, so probably he should know his finance skills very well. So I think that worked in my, despite the fact that there could be 6 who really never cared. So I think that's why I think it's a good thing to have it. It's a gold standard in the line of finance, but it can't make or break your career.
Okay. Yeah, that's nice. So, like you applied for your Blackstone, you had the interview as well. So, asking about these top-notch firms like BCG, Blackstone, McKinsey, Bain, all these consulting or private equity, what are some of the traits, according to you, which these companies are looking for in a candidate, apart from these technical skills? So, I understand that they are, of course, looking for these industry knowledge, then whether you are able to ask the right questions. But apart from this, what are some of the other traits which they are looking for in a candidate?
Yeah, right. I think what these candidates look for, I think it's very important that your communication skills should be very strong.
Okay.
They can connect with you at a very grounded level. Another thing that these firms actually do is it's called the airport test. Whether you would want
what
to be stuck
called?
At the airport.
I just lost you. What it is called?
It's called the airport test.
Okay.
It's basically whether you would want to be stuck at the airport with them or not.
Okay. All right.
Let's say whether you're flying and the flight's delayed for 3-4 hours, whether you would complain about being stuck with that person or not. So I think that way you should be very interesting enough for them. I think that's common across these consulting and private equity firms. The other thing is they'd want to see is whether two very important values, I think excellence and integrity, these two are synonymous across all these firms.
Okay.
One more thing I would want to see is I think co-curriculars are very important. A lot of times people just focus too much on content and that kills their personality. I think that's why it's very important to do things like other cultural things and just add to your skill set. I mean, you can talk about movies, you can talk about TV shows, you can talk about music, you can talk about theater, you can talk about fest, you can talk about sports. But if you just look at doing things that are productive for you on a content basis, that doesn't help. You need to, you know, give back to the society in terms of other performing arts or anything like that as well.
Right.
And they do help and they add a lot to your personality. I think these are the basic skills that probably help a lot to impress an interviewer.
Okay, yeah, sounds nice. So I think these are some of the skills which people need to adopt, and like they would be able to adopt these in terms of having an exposure in a college or extracurricular activities. Everything is going to matter in order to get a job in the future. So one more question which I'd like to ask, if a person who is in his articleship days or in his industrial training, if he wants to get into a private equity firm, if that is the ultimate goal, like you had this particular goal in your mind, so what would you advise to this particular person? How can he climb the ladder in order to ultimately reach private equity firm? And what all he should do right from now itself so that he can reach his goal of being recruited in a private equity firm? You can additionally mention, like, if you were reading something from a particular newspaper or a particular book, you can share that. Or you can just share what you used to do in your daily life that helped you get a good grip over finance.
I think if someone is in the articleship phase, I think the best thing that they can do for themselves is definitely try to get a rank, because it is almost like a gating condition to get into private equity that you have a rank as a CA. Because there are very few spots, like 10 or 12 spots in private equity for the position of an analyst, and thousands of people want that spot.
Right.
So getting a rank really makes that cut, and sounds harsh, but it really makes a big difference.
Okay.
And other than that, obviously, if your fundamentals of finance should be very strong, SFM has to be a favorite subject. You can't not like SFM and then say that, okay, I want to do private equity or VC, because ultimately all you're doing is looking at valuations.
Right.
So that is something other than the fact that you need to focus on finance and you need to get your marks right. And then post that, like I said, that you should read a lot about industries, about finance, what's happening in the world. In terms of what you can do is read a lot about, if you see that some startup is raising funds, you should probably go read about what they do.
Okay.
And see what they're doing, who's investing in them, and what is working for them. So these are things that it will help you understand business itself, the operations also. So today, let's say if we talk about something like in Oyo, we can take it as a case study. What worked for them 5 years back? What are the hurdles that they're facing right now? What could be the impact of COVID, post-COVID? How would they recover? Why are they, say, doing very well in India, but they're not doing well in China? So or something like that. These are the kind of cases that they'll give you about understanding a business. It can be any business, right? So reading about different kind of businesses would help you solve problems, because it will be a real life business, right? The scenario that they put you in. So the more you well, the well-read you are, the better you'll be able to solve the problem. Other than that, I think just stay a bit more focused over what you want, and post that you should private. I mean, CAs as freshers do not get into private equity spots. So the kind of work that you get after CA also really helps. So top consulting firms, top IV firms, top management, trainee spots definitely help. So okay. if you are something like in a McKinsey, BCG, Bain or investment banker at Deutsche or Barclays or Vendors, or if you are at Hindustan Lever, Aditya Birla, ITC. So if you are coming from these positions, you definitely have that advantage.
Okay.
So right, get those right after college, after your CA finals. And then I think you should have a fair spot at applying for it. But at the same time, you should not hold it very passionately or emotionally about, okay, I want this. If I don't get this, okay, it's a big problem. Don't judge yourself because these are some things. Luck plays a very big factor over here. So you can't really plan these things.
Right, right. Makes sense. Exactly. So if you were to share any reading material, like did you used to go through a particular website or like Economic Now or some newspapers like Economic Times, Live Mint, or you just used to Google out a thing which you want to read? So what
The regular newspapers and notifications that I used to get, let's say if I get an insurance notification that a startup is raising funds, I would probably Google it and read about it or something.
All right.
So that is, so I think just follow the, I mean, it's good to follow Economic Times. And also I think the real news, if you start Googling things, if you get into that habit, I think that really helps you, you know, service your inquisition inside you.
Right.
So that is something that you have a habit throughout your life, that you need to have that hunt to go.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So reading is a must in order to have this kind of knowledge, right? So any last message which you would like to give to all the viewers, all the CA aspirants?
I think to all the CA aspirants, I think the the message I would tell them is that we've already chosen a very tough path for yourself. So I think it's very important to keep yourself very motivated and happy so that you can do all the hard work and rigor with a smile on your face. And do not burn yourselves too much because it's a marathon. So it's not a short 100-meter race. So you have to work hard for life. So just keep it very balanced and be healthy. And I think if you work hard, things should fall into place and you should get whatever you want. So all the best.
Yeah, that's awesome. That was kind of motivating as well. Thanks a lot, Divyansh, for taking out your precious time out of your busy schedule. I think this was a very insightful session for all the viewers as well. So wish you all the best for your future endeavors. And I hope this would be a useful session for all of them. So thanks once again for coming up on the show.
Thanks a lot, Kushal. Thank you for having me. I had a great time.
I hope this was an insightful session for all of you. Trust me, if you really want to get into a private equity, ultimately, you need to have a very strong basics of SFM subject. So try to read some books on finance or try to do a course on financial modeling so that you have a good grip over finance. Additionally, try to read some basic news on the newspaper as said by Divyansh and try to evaluate what is happening in this particular deal. What is the rationale? What is the deal value? Is it fairly valued, overvalued or undervalued? You know, you can read some analyst reports as well. There's a website called trendline.com. I read some analyst report from this particular website only and that is very helpful. So you can understand the basics of valuation from all these sources. If you want to get in touch with Divyansh, you can follow him on Instagram or you can connect with him on LinkedIn. I have given both of these links in the description box. At this point of time, I'd like to thank An Academy for sponsoring the video. For CA Foundation students, there is a marathon video on 21st of September at 12 PM sharp. So it is a long marathon revision video for law subject. You can very well watch the video. I will give the link of the video in the description box. And there are a lot of batches in An Academy for CA Intermediate and Foundation at a very subsidized cost of 3,500 for 1 month subscription. You can use my code, that is Kushal5, to get a 10% discount, and you can very well apply if you are interested for the same. So thank you so much guys for watching the video. I hope this video was useful for all of you, and subscribe to my channel so that I can create more videos for all of you. Thank you once again for watching the video. See you in the next video.